I got to bring up black sheep, you know, a wolf in sheep's clothing. Really, just a different record from 1991. Has one of my favorite posse cuts on it of all time called Past the 40. Just check it out. This is one of my favorites here. But Flavor of the Month is the track on this. It's their first single that was released on here. You know, and you may know Black Sheep for the song The Choice Is Yours. You can get with this or you can get with that. You know, engine number 9 on the New York Transit line. If my train falls off the track, pick it up, pick it, pick it up. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. You know, you probably heard some play on that at least. I know that's been used in commercials and stuff, but this was the first joint to come off of it. You know, it's a song about sex. I mean, this whole album is about sex, and it's a little less... it's a little less playful than the rest of the collective, but I just want you to kind of, you know, see a little bit of the diversity of the group, you know, the collective of Native Tongues. And this is just a real incredible, you know, album in itself. The cover's dope. You got Drez and Mr. Long with a bunch of sheep. It's just like, as literal as that is, it's still pretty fucking cool. Yeah, so there's that. And again, I bring this up because, again, you start talking about incredible sample elements here. The main loop is from the psych rock group, the Bubblegum Machine, I Wonder. That's the main loop on this. So just, again, like going into psych rock, finding different source material. It's just so, so much of what, you know, Native Tongues is about. And just to find like a, you know, a psych pop record like this and find a really killer dark loop off of it is pretty dope. And then use this drum break on here that, you know, I don't know if like Q-Tip put them up on it on this break, but it's a drum break called Upon This Rock. It's a Joe Farrell, which is a jazz record. It was used on verses from the Abstract, a Tribe Called Quest record. Our song first, I believe. But anyways, yeah, they hooked up that drum loop on that. Just another classic. So I just want, you know, get a sense of like, you know, Native Tongues, their lyrics, their vibe, their style, you know, how they collabed with one another, and then their music, man. And like, again, like, this is like the coolest shit about like this, like sample-based music, sample-based hip-hop music, is because it's like, it's your starting point. You know, like, it's your like entry point into all other types of music. You know, like, it is like how you find like all the other like dope things out there, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like reverse engineering, you know what I'm saying? Like, you listen to Midnight Marauders, right? And you go and you look at the liner notes, and liner notes are on the vinyl, they're on the company sleeve on the inside, you know? And we could go to, let's just find a War Tour. Contains a sample of We Gettin' Down, written and performed by Weldon Irving, courtesy of Nodeloo Music, da 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 da, you know, whatever. I mean, you can just, you and like, oh, I gotta find that Weldon Irving record. Like, that gives you like that didn't exist prior to like when record labels made you clear your samples. You didn't have to list them out, so it was all secretive, you know? Like, you didn't know what people were using. You would have to find it, you would just stumble across it, whatever. But once they had to start clearing stuff and then giving people credit on the liner notes, that made it real easy for people like me, you know, to go and start going to, you know, record stores and looking for the source material, looking for the drum breaks. Like, it gave you you know, this was your starting point, your entry point into sampling, because you go and try to find that stuff. You're like, oh, that fucking drums on you know, Can I Kick It are like incredible. I got to find that Lonnie Smith record. I need to find Drives because it's got that break on it. You know, it's insane. I need to have that. And that's like the amazing thing here. And if you listen to Native Tongues and you use that as your entry point into reverse engineering their music and finding the source material, it's going to put you into a whole different world of music than you've ever been into. And that is the beauty of sample-based stuff when those cats started getting into alternative source material. All right, that's the Native Tongues. I mean, it's really hard for me to blast that into, you know, a lecture. I could spend a whole class on the Native Tongues, but I encourage you to listen to the music of the Queen Latifah. Go check out some Jungle Brothers. If you've never listened to Tribe, try to stream some of their albums. Their first three albums specifically. After that, it's a lot of people out there in the class may be mad when I say J Dilla produced the two worst Tribe Called Quest albums, but it's the damn truth. look into some of the De La Soul's music, just check out the stuff, expand your horizons. I mean, that's part of what this class is about. Like, I want y'all to look not only at the hip hop music that we're talking about, you know, and explore the algorithm there, right? You go and look up in YouTube, Black Sheep, and the whole algorithm of shit that comes up in the sidebar, like go on an algorithm exploration, and see what else pops up there, and then start looking at some of the source material. It can really just expand your horizons of music, which is really what this class is about. Not only expanding your horizons, but putting music in its like social and historical context. So I'll check you around the way next time. And hope y'all are taking care of yourselves, feeling good, and I'll peep you on the flip. Peace.